You know, at this time, I almost feel it's necessary to go through and read all of the exemptions that are included within this particular piece of legislation. Some people in legislature over the years have talked about loopholes. They've talked about corporate exemptions. They've talked about corporate giveaways, and they have said they don't like those particular things. This legislation in front of us contains a record number of corporate loopholes, corporate exemptions, and corporate giveaways. I know of no other legislation in the 20 years in the legislature that I have been here that includes over 56 separate loopholes and giveaways to corporations to be included in a single piece of legislation. And what's particularly striking about these giveaways and these corporate loopholes that are created in this legislation is that it goes to the people that actually produce carbon. And so think about that for a second. What you're doing is you are exempting the companies that have the most lobbyists, and I appreciate that. As you look around Olympia and you go through the third house book and look at the people that have the most lobbyists in Olympia, they're the ones that get the exemptions. They're the ones that are carved out of this particular bill. So if you are a commercial bakery, if you poultry processing, if you have ice cream and frozen dessert manufacturing, if you do mayonnaise, dressing, and other prepared sauce manufacturing, you don't pay the carbon tax. Think about that for a second. Well, why are these particular ones carved out? Who do they know in Olympia? Fats and oils, refining and blending, breakfast cereal manufacturing, frozen fruit, juice, and vegetable manufacturing, you're exempt. You don't pay the carbon tax. You don't pay the energy tax in this particular bill. And the list goes on and on and on. Poultry hatcheries, turkey production, chicken egg production, wet corn milling, you're exempt. And so the question might be asked, who's not exempt in this particular piece of legislation? Well, if you have to truck your product in Washington State, you're not exempt. So if you're driving your product up and down the roads using diesel trucks, if you're a company that depends upon that, you're not exempt in Washington State. If you're a small manufacturer who might mill particular products, you're not exempt. But hold on a second. You're just not exempt. You get to pay the tax twice. And that is where this thing is incredibly frustrating to people who don't have enough lobbyists here in Olympia to get exempted. So if you're a small manufacturer that has to bring in natural gas or propane to do your business, you're taxed on the propane, you're taxed on the natural gas, and then you're taxed on the emission within your manufacturing process. So think of that for a second, because you didn't have enough lobbyists in Olympia to get an exemption, you get to pay the tax twice. And I am just shocked that members of this legislature, who for years and years and years have railed about closing corporate tax loopholes, are now proposing a bill with the most corporate tax loopholes ever introduced in Olympia. And there's some great ones in there. You also exempt aviation fuels. Now, is that important to exempt aviation fuels? I don't know. It might be a good thing to exempt aviation fuels, but what does that mean to working men and women in Washington State? That means when I drive my kids to school, when I drive my kids to basketball practice, if I am a working family with two people who have to go to work every day and we commute 100 miles a day because I have to drive 25 miles to work and my wife has to drive 25 miles to work every single day to go to work, you pay the tax. Now, if you're a corporate executive at Microsoft and you want to hop in the corporate jet and fly to the Bahamas to play golf, you do not pay the tax. So working families in Washington State, just think about that one for one second. Corporate executives do not have to pay the tax for the fuel that goes into their corporate jets to fly around the world, but you have to pay the tax to drive to work. That's amazing. That is absolutely amazing. And let's talk about the other part of this. So supposedly the goal of this is to reduce carbon. That's what some people say about this bill. So if the goal is to reduce carbon, why do I exempt over 56 companies who produce carbon? 56 industry groups, not 56 companies, 56 industry groups. Shocking. Shocking. That's how we're structuring this bill. So who pays the tax at the end of the day? Who are the people that are not exempt? I can tell you, these are the people that don't have lobbies. They're the working men and women of Washington State. Because at the end of the day, with all of these corporate tax exemptions, all these loopholes that are created, it's the people that have to pay for gas and pay to heat their home who pay the tax. So why not make it fair? Make the 1% pay the tax. Make the corporate executives pay the tax. Make the corporations pay the tax. Eliminate these exemptions. Because right now, the only people in Washington State who pay the tax are the people that work for a living. Lower class people, middle class people who got to drive. They can't afford a Tesla. They can't afford to go out and buy those cars. They're not plugging their cars in. They're going to the gas station and filling up. And maybe in 15 years, technology expands and people are able to drive gas, battery-powered cars. That's great. We should invest in technology. But today, for the next 15 years, you're telling those people you matter less than the corporate executive who gets the tax exemption, and you're going to pay more. This is shocking. It's appalling. It is a slap in the face of working people in Washington State that you have you care about the environment. You care about the climate. So how am I going to solve the climate crisis in the world? I'm going to tax you more to drive your kids to school. And what will that do to help save climate temperature? Absolutely zero. Nothing. But it will take more money from your family so you can do less. So some people in Olympia can feel better about themselves. And so some corporations can say, oh, I'm not going to get an initiative, and now I feel better about how I can get some carve-outs in Olympia. This is killing working families. It is killing working people in Washington State. And we should adopt this amendment, and we should kill this bill in general.